Antiarrhythmic drugs are a class of medications that are administered for the treatment of cardiac arrhythmias. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. When it comes to pharmacology and respiratory care, most people only think about the medications that are given to affect the lungs. The heart and cardiovascular system is often overlooked. However, it's important to remember that respiratory therapists are trained to provide care for patients with conditions of both the heart and lungs. That is because these two major organs work together to pump oxygenated blood to all of the cells and tissues within the body. Therefore, if a disease is inhibiting the functionality of the heart, it could inadvertently affect the lungs as well. All of that to emphasize the fact that cardiovascular drugs are an important class of medication to learn and understand. There are a few primary types, however, for this video, we're specifically focusing on antiarrhythmic agents. As previously mentioned, antiarrhythmic agents are administered for the treatment of cardiac arrhythmias. This is when there is a problem with the rate or rhythm of the patient's heartbeat. For example, the patient's heart could be beating at a rate that is too fast or slow, or it's possible that their heart may be skipping beats as well. Some examples of the most common types of antiarrhythmic agents include the following: amiodarone, procainamide, verapamil, and lidocaine. Amiodarone is a drug that is often administered during ACLS for the treatment of life-threatening heart rhythm disorders. This includes ventricular tachycardia and ventricular fibrillation. Procainamide is a similar drug that is indicated for the management and treatment of both ventricular and supraventricular arrhythmias. This includes atrial flutter and atrial fibrillation. It is often administered in patients with Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome as well. Next up is Verapamil, which is a calcium channel blocker medication that is indicated for the treatment of supraventricular tachycardia and is effective in controlling the ventricular rate. Lidocaine is often known for being a local anesthetic. However, it can also be administered intravenously for the treatment of ventricular arrhythmias. In such a case, it can be given as an alternative to amiodarone for the management of ventricular tachycardia or ventricular fibrillation. Lidocaine may also be used in patients with a myocardial infarction or ischemia as well. Some other types of cardiovascular drugs to be familiar with include inotropic agents, vasodilators, anti-anginal drugs, and vasopressors, each of which are medications that we've discussed in other videos here on our channel. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel, and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.